गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू यू इन टुडेज लेक्चर। डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी हैड सीन फर्स्ट टू टाइप्स ऑफ द प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर, लाइक परफेक्टली इलास्टिक डिमांड एंड सेकेंड इज परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक डिमांड। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रिमेनिंग टाइप्स ऑफ द प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। So, next types of price elasticity of demand is unitary elastic demand, which is unitary elastic demand. So, first we will discuss about definition, then diagram with formula. So, when percentage change in price leads to proportionate change in quantity demanded for a particular commodity, it is called as unitary elastic demand. क्या? So here, change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded. Change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded. This triangle denotes change. Change in price is exactly equals to change in quantity demanded. It means when percentage change in price leads to proportionate change in quantity demanded is called as unitary elastic demand. In this case, percentage change in price is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded. It means change in quantity demanded is equal to change in price, and therefore it is called as unitary elastic demand. In this case, change in quantity demanded is exactly equals to change in price. So, when percentage change in price leads to proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as unitary elastic demand. Which type of demand? Unitary elastic demand. In this case, percentage change in price is exactly equals to percentage change in quantity demanded for a commodity. So here we may explain concept of unitary elastic demand with the help of a diagram also. So dear friends, we know that on y-axis we measure price of the commodity and on x-axis we measure quantity demanded for a commodity. So it is our origin point O. On y-axis we measures price of commodity and x-axis indicates quantity demanded for a commodity. So when there is unitary elastic demand, in this case change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded, and therefore whenever we will draw our demand curve, then we will take same measurement with respect to price and quantity demanded from origin point. So here price of the product is measured on y-axis, therefore we will take one point, we will measure same distance from origin point on y-axis as well as same distance from origin point on x-axis also. So here one scale we have taken here on x-axis also. So here join these two points with one another, but do not touch x and y-axis. So here we will join these two points. So it is our demand curve. It is our demand curve called as DD, demand curve. So here on this DD demand curve, suppose E is a point on the demand curve. So what will be quantity demanded on E points? What will be price of product on E points on the demand? So here we have major price on Y axis. Therefore, OP will be the price, and quantity demanded is measured on X axis. So here OQ will be the quantity demanded for a product. So on E point on the demand curve, OP is the price and OQ is the quantity demanded. Suppose price of the product is decreases. Suppose here on E1 point, we will take here E1 point. So what will be the price on E1 point? So P1, what will be price? P1, O P1, and quantity demanded Q1. So here price of the product is changed. There is change in price. What will be the change in price? P P1. What will be change in price? P P1. And what is the exact change in quantity demanded? Q Q1. What will be the change in quantity demanded? Q Q1. Q Q1. It is actual change in quantity demanded. And change in price? P P1. Suppose it is 10%, change in price 10%. As a result, change in quantity demanded also same, because in this case change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded. So observe our demand curve, observe our diagram. PP1 is exactly equals to QQ1, and therefore change in quantity demanded also 10%. So change in quantity demanded 10%, which is equal to change in price also 10%. So here we will explain unitary elastic demand with the help of formula also. You know that price elasticity of demand is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded of X divided by percentage change in price of X. So put the value into the formula. Q Q1 will be the change in quantity demanded. Q Q1 divided by change in price P P1. So here change in quantity demanded 10% divided by change in price also 10%. So 10% divided by 10% is equal to 1. So here answer of our formula, price elasticity of demand is equal to 1, and therefore it is called as unitary elastic demand. Therefore it is called as unitary elastic demand. In this case, answer of the formula of PED will be 1, and DD is our demand curve, where change in price PP1 is exactly equals to change in quantity demanded QQ1. So and therefore our demand curve DD will be called as rectangular hyperbola. DD will be called as, it means demand curve, slope of demand curve will be called as rectangular hyperbola, because in this case change in price is exactly equals to change in price, and when there is unitary elastic demand, then demand curve will be rectangular hyperbola. So here change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded, and therefore when percentage change in price leads to proportionate change in quantity demanded for a commodity is called as unitary elastic demand. In another word, it can be defined as when change in price is equal to change in quantity demanded, it is called as unitary elastic demand. So then second or next types of price elasticity will be relatively elastic demand. Next one is relatively elastic demand. So here first we will define the concept of relatively elastic demand and then we will explain it with the help of diagram as well as with the help of formula also. So when percentage change in price leads to more than proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively elastic demand. Yeah, when percentage change in price leads to more than proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively elastic demand. In a simple language, we can call as when percentage change in quantity demanded is more than percentage change in price, it is called as relatively elastic demand. When percentage change in quantity demanded is more than percentage change in price, it is called as relatively elastic demand. In another word, it can be defined as when percentage change in price is less than percentage change in quantity demanded, it is also known as relatively elastic demand. So here change in quantity demanded is more than change in price, and therefore when percentage change in price leads to more proportionate change in quantity demanded for a particular commodity, then demand for that commodity will be relatively elastic demand. So here we will explain it with the help of diagram also. So whenever we will draw demand curve with respect to relatively elastic demand, to yahan par change in quantity demanded is more than change in price, and you know that quantity demanded is measured on x axis and price of the product is measured on y axis. Therefore more demand or more change in quantity demand, so therefore we will take more distance from the origin point on x axis where we have measured quantity demanded for product, so and therefore we will take full one scale distance here, and there is less change in quantity price of the product may come change hai, isliye price of the product which is measured on y axis, तो यहां पर हम थोड़ा कम डिस्टेंस लेंगे क्योंकि चेंज इन प्राइस कम है. सो हियर वी विल टेक ओनली हाफ स्केल. एंड नाउ ज्वाइन दिस टू पॉइंट्स. सो इट विल बी आवर डिमांड कर्व. It will be our demand curve called as DD. It will be our demand curve which is called as DD. So here suppose it is E point on the demand curve. So what will be price of the product on E point? OP. What will be price of the product? OP. And quantity demanded will be OQ. OQ quantity is demanded when price is OP on a point on the demand curve. Suppose price of the product is changes. Suppose price of the product is changes and it become P1. So here we will take one point. E1 point. When price is OP1 and quantity demanded OQ1. So here on the E1 point on the demand curve, on the E1 point on the demand curve, price of the product is OP1. It means price is decreases and as a result quantity demanded changes. But there is more change in quantity demanded. So change in quantity demanded will be QQ1 and change in price PP1. So here we can observe that there is more change in quantity demanded than change in price. It means when change in quantity demanded is more than change in price. Dekho, PP1 change in price, QQ1 change in quantity demanded. Aap yadi usko observe karte hai, to we can find out that there is more change in quantity demanded than change in price. So here PP1 say QQ1. So QQ1, it means change in quantity demanded, is more than change in price. So suppose change in price is 5% and change in quantity demanded is 10%. So here price elasticity of demand is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded of X divided by percentage change in price of X. So change in quantity demanded QQ1, QQ1, change in price PP1 divided by PP1. So here change in quantity demanded suppose 10%, change in price 5%. So 10% divided by 5%, what will be the answer? Answer will be 2. What will be the answer of our formula? 2. And 2 is more than 1. 2 is more than 1. And therefore, it is called as relatively elastic demand. Therefore, it is called as relatively elastic demand. In this case, answer of the formula of price elasticity of demand is more than 1. And therefore, known as relatively elastic demand. So in this case, it means when demand is relatively elastic, then demand curve has flatter slope. Which type of slope? It has flatter slope, and flatter slope of the demand curve indicates relatively elastic demand. Which type of demand? Relatively elastic demand. And in this case, percentage change in price is less than percentage change in quantity demanded. In another word, percentage change in quantity demanded is more than percentage change in price. So in this way, relatively elastic demand can be explained. So when percentage change in price leads to more proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively elastic demand. In another word, when change in quantity demanded is when percentage change in quantity demanded is more than percentage change in price, it is also known as relatively elastic demand. Then last types of the price elasticity of demand, which is called as relatively inelastic demand. Last types. Last types of the price elasticity is relatively inelastic. Relatively inelastic demand. when percentage change in price, when percentage change in price leads to more less proportionate change in quantity demanded is called as relatively inelastic demand. When percentage change in price leads to less proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively inelastic demand. In another word, it can be defined as when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price. When percentage change in quantity demanded, when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, is also called as relatively inelastic demand. So in this case, change percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price. In another word, when percentage change in price is more than percentage change in quantity demanded, is called as relatively inelastic demand. So when percentage change in price leads to less proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively inelastic demand. In another word, it can be defined as when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, it is also called as relatively inelastic demand. In this case, percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price. So here we will explain the concept of relatively inelastic demand with the help of diagram also. Dear student, whenever we will draw the diagram, so here change in price is more and price is measured on y-axis. Therefore, take more distance from the origin point on the y-axis. Suppose we have taken one full scale on y-axis, and you know quantity demanded is measured on x-axis and there is less change in quantity demanded. Therefore, take a very short distance here from the origin point. Suppose here we have taken only half scale. So in this way, now join these two points. So it is our demand curve called as DD. It is our demand curve called as DD. So on suppose it is E point on the demand curve. Suppose it is a E point on the demand curve where price of the product is OP. Where price of the product is OP because price is measured on Y and quantity demanded is measured on x-axis, and therefore quantity demanded will be OQ. How many quantity is demanded there? OQ. OQ quantity is demanded and price is OP. So here price of the product, it changes and it decreases. Price of the product is decreases and it become P1. Price of the product is decreases and it become P1. So OP1 will be price. And when, how many units is demanded? Q1. OQ1. Price jab Q1, P1 hoti hai, to quantity demanded kitni hai? Q1 hai. So with respect to E1 point on the demand curve, price is OP1 and quantity demanded is OQ1. So here, what will be change in price? PP1. What will be change in price? PP1. And as a result, quantity demanded mein hone wala change hai QQ1. Change in quantity demanded QQ1 and change in price PP1. If we observe these two change, it means change in price and change in quantity demanded, we can conclude that there is less change in quantity demanded and more change in price. And therefore, when percentage change in quantity demanded is more, when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, it means there is more change in price of the product and quantity demanded mein hone wala change kam hai. So here suppose change in price 10% and change in quantity demanded, change in quantity demanded suppose it is 5%. So here we will put the value into the formula and we know that price elasticity of demand is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded of x divided by percentage change in price of x. So here percentage change in quantity demanded of x q1, what will be change in quantity demanded, kyunki pehle quantity demanded oq and now oq1, so exact change in quantity demanded q se q1, so q1 is the change in quantity demanded and change in price p1, kyunki pehle price p thi and now ab p1 hai, so exact change in price is pp1. Suppose it is 10% and change in quantity demanded 5%, so pp1, so change in quantity demanded 5%, change in price 10%, 5% divided by 10%, answer will be 0.5. what will be answer? 0.5, and which is less than 1, which is less than 1, and therefore it is called as relatively inelastic demand. Which type of demand? Relatively inelastic demand. In this case, answer of the formula of price elasticity of demand is less than 1, 0.5, less than 1, relatively inelastic demand. Because here change in quantity demanded, change in quantity demanded is less than change in price. So here pp1, change in price, more than change in quantity demanded qq1. In another word, qq1 is less than change in pp1. So here observe our demand curve bd, which type of slope it has? It has steeper slope. Which type of slope? Steeper. So demand curve has steeper slope when there is relatively inelastic demand. So demand curve has steeper slope when demand is relatively inelastic. So with respect to relatively inelastic demand, demand curve has steeper slope and answer of the our formula of PED will be less than 1. So in this way, when percentage change in price leads to less proportionate change in quantity demanded, it is called as relatively inelastic demand. In another word, when percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, it is also called as relatively inelastic demand. So इस प्रकार आज की लेक्चर में हमने प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड के तीन प्रकार, उनकी डेफिनेशन, मीनिंग विथ फार्मूला एंड डायग्राम, उनको एक्सप्लेन किया है. तो आज का लेक्चर अब यहाँ पर हम उसे पूर्ण विराम देते हैं. थैंक यू.